Hello, everybody. Sunday at Elijah here. Let's see who is going to be the first person to greet us today. I know we just finished a live broadcast a few minutes ago. Like 10 minutes ago, we just finished a live broadcast. But that live broadcast was not my broadcast. That live broadcast was for the face of DSA. It's for the DSA family. For the hero, DSA family hero. And like Matrak of Pastors of DSA family. You know, I think we could call Anastasia McDonough the Matrak of DSA family. So that live program was for her. And it's Anastasia that was having a birthday yesterday and she flew into bed. It was just all worked out very well. So we needed to celebrate a birthday in a family way and welcome her home. Now we have Mofelola, welcome. Favor Umana, Innocent Magaji, Unyibo Oluwaseun, Oriyomi Anota, Innocent Magaji, Shola Lamodi, Izeko Mofi, Tantoloro Agape, and welcome everyone. Welcome. Nice to see you. And like you know, today is the last day that we have in our marathon. Today is the last day for our marathon, and the person in charge is Olena Stebeska. She's our host, and she's going to be interviewing the next hero that we have today.
Добрий вечір усім.
Good evening, everyone.
Раді вас бачити уже на 28-му марафоні.
Today is the 28th day of our long birthday marathon.
Присвяченому пастору Сандею, де ми дізнаємося про роль пастора у житті українських, російських людей.
We are celebrating Pastor Sunday's birthday, 28th day going, to acknowledge and, you know, to appreciate all his investment in our people, in the people of Ukraine, and by hearing the stories of Ukrainian people, of how Pastor Sunday has influenced their lives.
І, звичайно, не віриться, що це вже сьогодні закінчується, 28-й день, і наостанок у нас є чудові гості, вони з Росії приїхали.
Unfortunately, we cannot right now. We cannot continue. We will not be able to continue this broadcast after today because today Pastor Sunday celebrates. Tomorrow Pastor Sunday celebration begins, and once that starts, you know, it will be all live broadcast and celebration. So we will not be. You know, today is going to be our last session, our last interview, our last day of this marathon.
І сьогодні у нас в гостях пастор Олексій Астахов і його дружина Марія.
So let me present to you our hero today. We have a couple today. That is Pastor Олексій and the wife Maria. Mary.
І сьогодні ми почуємо чудову історію їх життя і дізнаємося, як пастор Сандей вплинув на їх сьогоднішній.
I want us to hear their stories and how Pastor Sunday influenced them.
Пастор Олексій, здравствуйте, пастор Марія.
Пастор Олексій, how are you today?
Я хочу вам задати вопрос по поводу пастора 50-летнього юбілею. Звісно, не віриться, що йому 50-летнього.
Can you believe it, that Pastor Sunday is already 50 years old?
Ну, завтра ми починаємо праздник, тому що для вас лично означає 50-летнього?
What is Pastor Sunday's birthday? What does that mean to you, лично или вообще?
Вообще.
Вообще?
Ну, 50 лет такая круглая цифра.
You know, we all know that 50 is like is a major figure in life.
Обычно люди подводят определенные итоги.
At 50 is time for to make conclusions.
И надо сказать, что у пастора Сандея есть какие итоги подвести.
Yes, Pastor Sunday has what to summarize.
И мы с супругой являемся тоже частью его плодов.
I and my wife, we are fruits of Pastor Sunday.
Я мотиватор и бизнес-тренер.
I'm a coach, I'm a motivator and a business coach.
И на сегодня это рубеж, когда можно было видеть большие плоды в жизни.
And this is a time of, you know, that we are going to do analysis of pastors, life and its results.
Написанные книги.
Pastor Sunday has a huge number of results.
Тысячи учеников.
He's written so many books.
Измененные целые страны.
But more than books, he's gotten disciples, thousands of disciples that carry his DNA. But even more than that, nations that have been touched, there have been tens of nations touched.
Да, да. Поэтому для меня юбилей пастора это такая дата, когда можно подвести итоги. И...
So, Pastor Sunday's birthday is a good time to summarize what God has done through him.
И увидеть перспективу, огромную перспективу.
But even more important than what God has done through Pastor Sunday is the future of what God is trying to do and about to do in the future through the life of Pastor Sunday.
Ну, я продолжу эту же тему, и мне кажется, что пастор Сандей этот юбилей является таким примером жизни, как нужно прожить свою жизнь, как можно за такое короткое время, 50 лет, столько много успеть. Yeah.
For me, Pastor Sunday's life is a standard, is an example of how a person should live his life to get the maximum result, because for Pastor Sunday's short lifespan, he's done so much, and it's a standard for everybody that wants to achieve much in his life.
Пастор Сандей, он учитель, философ, ментор, автор множества книг, тысячи, и он поднял очень многих людей.
Pastor Sandey is a teacher, he's a preacher, he's a pastor, he's an author, he's a writer, he's a philosopher, he's a thinker. He's raised up thousands of people.
Также он реформатор и просто великий человек.
He's a great guy. He's a great man, a reformer.
Я считаю, что мне повезло, что я знакома в своей жизни
For me, it's a life gift that I got to know this man человеком. In my lifetime. That just, I think, destiny and life and fate have just done me a great favor that I got to meet him in my lifetime.
Я хотел добавить, что этот юбилей также еще возможность для всех нас, его детей духовных, собраться и порадовать нашего пастора плодами.
Another thing is that, when Pastor Sunday is having his birthday like this, all his children from most places come together. So it's a good time for us to meet together with our family members from different places and to also share our results, the results that we are producing thanks to him.
Поэтому, с одной стороны, это официальное мероприятие, а с другой стороны, это семейная встреча.
So, on one end is a family gathering, family reunion.
А вы помните, как вы впервые познакомились с пастором? Расскажите, пожалуйста.
Do you remember your meeting, your first meeting with Pastor Sunday?
Это очень хорошая история, так хочешь?
Мы первый раз познакомились с пастором Сандеем в 2002, наверное, в 2002 или 2001 году. Это было в Киеве, мы приехали в Киев и на конференцию бизнесменов полного Евангелия. И она проходила... забыла.
Ну, в Киеве.
Да, в Киеве. И на ней также был пастор Сандей, и он учил о финансах. Была тема мудрости. Лидерская школа была мудрости. И я помню, что мы подошли к пастору Сандею, и он нас пригласил на эту лидерскую школу.
I remember my first meeting with Pastor Sandey. We were here in Kyiv for a business meeting, and Pastor Sandey was teaching there. And also, Pastor Sunday was conducting a leadership school in Kiev on the topic of wisdom. And so we attended that meeting.
Я хотел... Важная вещь. Дело в том, что как мы туда попали. Мы были верующими уже 5 лет. И к этому времени полностью разочарованными в христианстве.
So at that point, I want to add to this, because at this point, we were already believers. We were believers for 5 years, and we had just been disillusioned in the church, in people, in leadership, in pastors. We've just been disappointed people.
Ну, был духовный кризис.
So we were, in a wilderness kind of.
Потому что, да, мы видели, что в Библии написано, как нужно жить. Но жить так не могли.
We, but also we were also having a lot of disappointment in our Christian work. We saw the standards of the Bible, but we couldn't live like that, and we believed that the Christians and the leaders that were around us were not living according to that standard. So we were not sure if this is what we wanted to continue or not.
Мы, например, искали наоборот людей, которые так же, как мы, не жили по ценностям Царства.
So we were actually looking for people that were going to, you know, be correspondent to these values.
Чтобы убедиться, что это нормально. Вот. И несколько месяцев помолились и получили приглашение в Киев на конференцию.
So when we were just praying and wondering what we should do with our lives, then that was when we were invited to Kiev.
И там были учителя из Англии, из Америки.
So there were many teachers from England, from America.
Два дня они рассказывали нам, я сидел и спал.
But all these teachers from England, from the West, from America, when they were teaching, I was sleeping.
И когда пришел пастор Сандей?
But when Pastor Sunday took over,
я сел, посмотрел на него.
I was looking at him first, just gauging him out.
Чему может меня научить этот темнокожий?
You know, but I was very skeptic because I was thinking, hey, black guy, you know what I mean? I couldn't get anything from the Americans and from the Europeans, and now they brought a black guy. What would this ever be? It's an insult on my intelligence. What can a black man teach me? What can I learn from a black person? Especially, I'm a businessman at this point, and I was a successful businessman. As a successful businessman, what can a black guy teach me about business? I mean, from Africa, I cannot teach you about business. I mean, that is the truth. I mean, there's nothing to learn from an African. Nothing to learn from an African. But Pastor Sunday spoke for just 1 hour. After 1 hour, I came to the conclusion, this guy knows something that nobody else knows. This guy knows something. This guy has access to some information that is rare. He has some direct contact with heaven or something. He has some source that is downloading on him. So after the meeting, I just told him, let's find our way to find this guy. So I went, we decided to approach him and ask him, can we get to know you? Can we meet you?
Потому что мы были полностью разбиты.
And, you know, because at this point we were so disillusioned in everybody. But this was a ray of light, that maybe a ray of hope.
Только номинальные верующие.
That maybe this could help us because we were already on our way out of Christianity at this point.
Ну, мы увидели, что Бог действует через это.
But we saw something in this man. We saw that this guy possesses something. He speaks like nobody else speaks. Something, and he says things that nobody else has spoken about. Maybe there is somebody, there is something this guy knows that we don't know.
Пастор Санди сказал, приходите завтра в церковь, у нас будет конференция.
So Pastor Sunday then invited us to his conference that he was doing on leadership.
Мы пришли прямо с вещами.
So we came.
С одеждой. Это было в марте месяце. И пошли к сцене. Было прекрасное прославление. И мы шли к сцене и думали, когда же нас остановят?
Нас никто не остановил, я помню.
Нас никто не остановил.
Because that was the first time we were entering into his church. Because this is leadership class was in his church. I mean, the other one was in the hotel. But here, we were coming to his church. But when we came in, we were expecting the protocols or the ushers to stop us. We were just walking in with our bags and our coats. Normally in church, they don't allow you to come in with your top coats, overall coats, and your bags from the, like you are coming from the red train station. So, but we were coming in and we were going through the whole hall, and nobody was stopping us, right into the front. And normally, they had, in normal churches, you have people sitting down, resignated places, and they don't just allow anyone to go.
Я помню, что первые ряды были заняты места, и пастор Санде, увидя нас, ну, нашу компанию, он, что мы так рвемся вперед, он сказал, принесите стулья вперед, поставьте, пожалуйста.
So what happened was that because the hall was filled up and the places in front were filled, Pastor Sunday asked for people to bring extra chairs to the front, even ahead of his own chair, to sit down there in front.
И он принял нас совсем чужих людей.
We couldn't believe this. He doesn't even know us. We are strangers to him, but he's sitting us right in the first row.
Как родные.
As we were the most important people there.
15 лет мы вместе, и это наш дом.
it's like we've been there for 15 years, as if we are the leaders of this church. Then that reception and that attitude of acceptance just made us to know that no, these are home. We are no more living here. We are not living Christianity. We are not living God, and we are not living this church anymore. So we are very lucky. I think we are very lucky that we have met this person in our lifetime. I think it's God. It's a divine meeting. God set this up for us. So God brought us across Pastor Sunday.
Какие вы имеете сегодня результаты благодаря пастору? Кто вы, чем вы занимаетесь?
How has your life changed? What are the results you now have thanks to pastors, your meeting with Pastor Sunday?
Я сегодня мотиватор.
Today I'm a coach, I'm a trainer, business trainer.
Business trainer, да.
I'm a business coach.
У меня есть группы предпринимателей по всей стране.
So I coach people all over Russia. I have disciples all over the country.
Я редактор одной книги и соавтор.
I'm also a writer and an author. Two books.
И сегодня я имею страницу в Фейсбуке и имею ежедневные прямые трансляции.
And I have, and I'm a host on Facebook Live program. I do my live program on daily basis every day.
Я консультирую на русскоязычном пространстве.
But almost also I'm working as a consultant to business people.
Провожу тренинги.
И сейчас... All over Russia and of course to training and coaches and seminars.
И у нас есть лидерский центр, в котором
and I also have, I also run a leadership center.
Люди могут приезжать и находиться там, их жизни меняются.
Leadership center where people could come to and learn and even stay over and live and stay with us and get trained and get, you know, be given directions.
До сих пор мы арендовали, но вот вчера я оплатил уже землю, мы будем строиться.
Wow.
Это то, что дал нам пастор. Масштаб.
Right now, before now in Moscow, we only rented every place we were using, all our facilities were rented. But yesterday, I just paid for a piece of land in this Moscow city, and we are going to build a center, our own center over there.
Это только начало, потому что мы ориентируемся на нашего, ну, отца и тренера, на пастора.
Because pastor encourages us to never be average and be mediocre, that we should go and be the best and do the most we can do.
Поэтому мы планируем влиять на, ну, тысячи и сотни тысяч людей.
So my target is to be able to influence hundreds of thousands of people.
И мой инструмент – это тренерство, это предпринимательство.
So our instrument of lead of influence is training for businessmen.
Yeah. Пожалуйста.
How much is using vanilla espresso?
Да.
Can you get
С тех пор, как вы встретились с пастором, какие у вас результаты? Вы рассказали, кто вы есть на сегодняшний день. Возможно, я уточню вопрос. Благодаря чему, каким принципам вам удалось всего этого достичь?
Ну, я уже говорил, что придя на встречу с пастором Сандеем, я был внутренне разбит.
So the first result after meeting Pastor Sunday was that I was healed from inside.
И я сказал внешние результаты. Но на самом деле, самое главное, это то, что общение с пастором и принцип позволили мне выстроить внутренний стержень.
But the most important, you know, thing that happened was that after being healed, because like I said, we were disillusioned. So I was healed from that disappointment.
Полностью.
I didn't want to leave God anymore.
Полностью выстроить личность.
I got excited about God. I wanted to live for God. But then after that, what happened was the teachings and the trainings of Pastor Sunday helped me to build myself from inside. So the value system, the building wall of my personality were built, and I became a personality from inside.
Это может быть самое главное достижение.
I think this is probably the most important thing for you to have the keys of life, the principles of life. That's the core. My core was restored. My foundation. I could stand firm now. My confidence, my self-assurance came back because of these teachings. I became aware of who I am, and I became aware of my authority, my place. I began to believe in myself, and just my core was restored. I found myself. I began to live again. So thanks to this meeting with Pastor Sunday today, I'm a person of value systems. I know exactly who I am in life. I know exactly the goals and the missions that I need to accomplish in my lifetime. But most, even more importantly than that, I have the plans and the schedule and the, of accomplishing these goals. So, and then, and above that, I've also been taught to live my everyday bringing forth results. So every day of my life is moving closer to my goals and touching my goals and yeah, and bringing to pass the dreams and the visions that I have for my life. So, like I said, I came here, I was ready to quit church, quit God, and I was a broken person.
Сегодня тот человек, который самодостаточен, и я служу другим людям.
But right now, I'm not just self-sufficient, I'm more than that. I'm a life giver. I'm a life coach, life giver to other people. I am now the life giver, the center of life for other people. I now give other people directions. I give them healing. I give them restoration. I give them direction in life.
Ну, я, наверное, про себя расскажу. Я просто я помню, когда перед тем, как познакомиться с пастором Сандеем, у меня было такое мировоззрение, что я считала, что женщина, она должна помогать мужу, что ее призвание быть помощницей мужу, и больше ничего не надо. И когда меня спрашивали, кем ты хочешь быть, я всегда говорила, ну, достаточно уже. Вот. И вот благодаря учению пастора, благодаря тому, то, что он всегда поднимает женщин, служит женщинам очень много, благодаря его ну, ретритам, я увидела, ну, я поняла то, что мое призвание не только быть женой, вот, что я сама могу, что у меня есть что у меня есть призвание. И это, наверное, ключевое такое.
I think the most important thing that happened to me personally is that before I came to meet Pastor Sunday, we had been a believer. We have been believers before in another church. And in that church, the understanding that we were given is that as a woman, that my calling was to be a helper to another person, who is my wife, my husband. So can you imagine it? I had all my education, I had my skills, I had my specialty, and now because I became born again, I became useless. The only thing I could now do is just to say, okay, I'm supporting somebody if he needs my help in the first place. So I was just rendered useless and irrelevant. That changed very fast after I met Pastor Sunday. Because Pastor Sunday honors women so much. He promotes us. He promotes them. He establishes them. He gives you confidence. He lets you know that you are a personality all by yourself. Not because, thanks to your husband. That both the man and the woman are personalities and are people that are supposed to accomplish their goals. And so now, thanks to Pastor Sunday's teaching, I now know I am full. I am normal. I am okay. I am okay by myself. I am not a half person. I am a full person. Thanks to this teacher, I know that I am full. I'm okay. I can be okay by myself too. I can accomplish, I can please God by myself, not just through my husband. And I can accomplish God's goals and purpose for my life. And that I have a purpose too. And then I started doing all these things.
И сегодня я, конечно, я знаю свое призвание, я сегодня помогаю женщинам, и также узнать свое призвание, я консультирую женщин, занимаюсь...
пишу книги.
Пишу книги, да. Также,
аспирантуру.
Да. Пастор, вы лучше меня все знаете. Пишу книги. Вот, и да, интересуюсь политикой и также являюсь руководителем общественной организации «Пастор Церкви». Сегодня я ну, просто самодостаточно, ну, я личность, и это самое главное.
So today, the most important thing in my life is that I discovered that I'm a human being, I'm a full human being, I'm a full personality, and that means that I am a pastor, I'm a coach myself, a teacher, I'm a trainer, I'm a I'm doing my PhD right now. I am in politics. I am besides that, you know, political activities. I have an NGO for women. I'm an author. I'm a writer, write books, and so, you know, I'm living a full life. I discovered that I could live my full life, fulfilled life, thanks to this meeting.
Ну и, конечно, я помогаю.
Of course, I didn't stop helping my husband. I still help him whenever he needs my help. But I don't just stand around and wait till he needs my help. I do what I need to do for myself and for God.
Вообще, то, что меня удивило, когда я встретился с пастором Сандеем, что...
What are the principles that have helped you, that Pastor Sunday taught, that has helped you to become who you became?
Он учил нас всегда, что если вы будете поступать по принципам, можете стать такими же, как я.
You know, one thing that Pastor Sunday has taught us is that you know, anybody can be just like him. You know, Pastor Sunday instilled in us the faith that every one of us can achieve anything we want. Yeah. And we could become just like him, that he's no better than everyone, any one of us, that we are no worse than him, yeah. That we should learn his principles, his secrets, and go and establish ourselves just like him. Yeah. That was shocking.
Yeah, буквально несколько принципов. Главное, это основывать свою жизнь на слове, на общении с Богом.
So Pastor gave us a few principles, fundamental principles. Number one, personal relationship with God. This is what Pastor trained us in. Develop your own personal relationship with God.
Услышь от Бога, то есть получи от Бога, кто ты, ну, на чем тебе стоять.
Number two, learn to hear for God's voice. Learn to depend on Him. Learn to base your decisions and actions on your personal relationship with Him, not on what you've been taught by somebody or some other people's theories, I mean doctrines.
Принцип построения близких отношений с Богом, уединение.
That the most important thing you could do in your life is to become a friend of God. And that's what Pastor taught us. And he taught us that we must all practice solitude. So we started practicing solitude. He taught us how to practice solitude. He showed us how to do it, how to fast, how to pray. But not as a communion thing, not as a church program, that we should underplay church program and heighten up personal relationship with God. So Pastor Sunday emphasized his personal relationship rather than, you know, so just denominational kind of thing. So Pastor taught us that everything must come from your own conviction and from your own personal relationship with God. Another major thing that Pastor taught us to become who we are today is that he emphasizes a lot that you are here for a mission, that everyone is sent here on a purpose and on a mission, that you are not here just by accident. You are not here just to go to a job or to get an occupation. Yeah. That you are here, you are created from heaven by God to accomplish a certain purpose on earth.
Неважно, в каком состоянии пришел, неважно, сколько тебе лет, какого ты пола, у тебя есть великая судьба, и ты значим для Бога.
So Pastor Sunday convinced us that no matter what state you came to the church, it doesn't matter who you are, maybe you are a man, woman, poor, rich, homeless, addict, that no matter who you are, you were sent here on a purpose. What you are today is not, it doesn't matter. You can still go from where you are today to become who you were created originally to be by God. So by the way, if you have not shared the link, please, everybody watching this, go ahead and look for the share button and share the message. Go and share this link, please.
И третий принцип, коротко. Трудись, ну, по-настоящему для Бога. Выкладывайся, только тогда получишь результат. Никакой халявы.
The next principle that Pastor Sunday taught us is don't expect a result, even from God. Never hope on miracles, never hope on wonders, never hope on any result from God or from man without working for it. So make sure that you do your best. Do your best. Then God will come and bless what you have done. So don't just stand by waiting for miracle, but do your best, and then God will give you the miracle. So Pastor Tish taught us to do our best, to always, you know, give the best we can in everything. And those are the most important things.
Ну, наверное, Я добавил бы это саморазвитие. Да. То есть всегда изучать, узнавать что-то новое, видеть что-то новое и всегда познавать новое. Потому что очень часто, ну, я лично сталкивалась с таким, что я не могу исполнить, я знаю свое призвание, я куда-то что-то хочу сделать, но у меня не получается. Почему? Потому что у меня недостаток знаний. И да. То, что вот пастор нас научил, это то, что разберись, узнай, как это сделать, прочитай книгу. Да? Он научил нас читать о хотя бы минимум одну книгу в неделю, и слава Богу. Вот. А, вот я считаю, что это один из таких тоже ключевых принципов пастора.
Another major principle that pastor taught us is the need to do research and self-education. So pastor emphasizes self-education a lot. It pushes us to educate ourselves, to go for independent self-education and true research, that which don't take any decision just from nowhere. Make sure that you do the research, make sure you go into the details, make sure that you base whatever you are doing on self-education. And for example, if you are in his team, you have to read a book a week. So he made it a normal thing for us to read a book a week.
А скажите, пожалуйста, кто, по-вашему, пастор Санде как личность? Как вы можете его охарактеризовать вообще?
Для себя или вообще?
Вообще.
So who is Pastor Sunday as a whole? How would you describe Pastor Sunday?
Я думал, и мне очень сложно сравнить с кем-то, потому что он многогранный.
Now, Pastor Sunday, if you want me to compare him to somebody in history, that's almost impossible, because Pastor Sunday is so difficult to say, okay, he's just like this person or that person. Because Pastor Sunday has many facets to himself. He has many aspects of himself. He's so multifaceted. So there are many facets to Pastor Sunday. Let me mention a few of them. First of all, he's my spiritual father, so he's a spiritual giant.
Человек, который принял меня и любит меня.
So he's a loving person who cares about people, who lifts people, raises people, supports people, and gives people the protection and the covering that they need.
Также пастор очень успешный пастор.
So as a he's a spiritual father. Apart from that, Pastor Sunday is a very successful pastor.
Выдающийся учитель.
Very successful as a pastor, you know, one of the greatest churches in the world. Да. Then is also a great teacher.
Да. Писатель.
He's very talented.
Сотни книг.
Yeah, he teaches like no one does. But besides that, he's also a writer. Mm-hmm. He's written hundreds of books.
Да. Сегодня книги читают тысячи людей, верующие, неверующие, все жизни.
His books are just lifeline to believers and unbelievers in this part of the world. Unbelievers, everybody wants to get his book.
И также он реформатор.
But also another aspect of him is that he's a reformer, he's a revolutionary.
Да. Это очень важно, потому что, находясь с ним, мы часто не видим этот аспект.
Now, many times when you are with Pastor Sunday, you might not immediately see that.
Но посмотрев на его деятельность, уже сейчас мы видим измененные целые поколения.
When you look at his activities and the results of his movement, you will see that he has changed many generations already.
Это общественные организации, это политические.
All the projects that he comes up with, political projects, NGO projects, church, social projects, schools, education projects, all of them are national and international in their scope.
И если сказать одним словом, ну, кто он, то...
So to use one word to describe Pastor Sunday?
Я бы сказал так. Он ученик Иисуса Христа.
It's almost impossible. But I would just say, Pastor Sunday is, of course, Christ's follower.
Mm-hmm. Который открывает на земле полноту личности Христа.
Who reveals the magnitude and the fullness of God on the earth. He reveals the magnitude and the fullness of God on earth.
Который был для учеников и отцом, и другом, и реформатором.
So he is able to reveal God in any area and in any way that God is needed to be revealed at that particular time. So he could reveal God as a loving father at a point, then he could reveal God as a teacher, he could reveal God as a friend, he could reveal God as a mentor, he could reveal God as a leader. Just he is revealing God in every aspect that will just glorify him.
Пастор Алексей так много рассказал. Но для меня тоже пастор Сандей, конечно, является отцом в первую очередь и человеком, к которому всегда можно прийти с любой проблемой. И прийти как к отцу, рассказать какую-то свою проблему, он всегда даст выход, всегда поможет. И это, конечно...
You can always come to him with any problem, with any situation. He will always understand you and cover for you and give you, you know, and receive you and give you understanding
и, and solution as well. Наверное, может быть, из того, что еще не сказано, может быть, это мыслитель, потому что, пастор, он не только писатель, но его труды, они просто принципы, которые он применяет, то, что он...
And also, he's a thinker. Pastor Sunday is a thinker. He's a philosopher. He has original thoughts and concepts, and the thoughts that he brings to pass, I mean, he brings up. They always relate to life, and he's always establishing them and making them to be reality in the life of people around him.
Его концепции, они меняют не только жизни людей, но также и целые страны. Да. Могут изменить целые страны. Да? Может быть, кто-то
His
читал...
His concepts are so solid, mm-hmm. and they are so genuine, that mm-hmm. his teachings and concepts are capable of not just changing individual lives, but they are capable of changing nations as well.
Его книги о принципах национального возрождения, о как стать европейцем, они... просто дают новые какое-то движение, перспективу в стране.
Pastor Sunday has written books on how to build a nation, how to build a civilized nation, how to restore a nation, how to reform a nation. Yes, you know, he's done so much work in that area, in that concept, that that is actually, you know, he has concepts and ideas to change individuals and nations.
Мы живем в странах постсоветского периода и, конечно же, переживаем какие-то сложные периоды. И вот в его книгах это есть выход.
Yeah. You know,
он показывает этот выход.
Another thing with him is that his teachings address all situations in the society. So no matter what situation the society is going through or what problem exists in the society, he has some solutions. So his teachings are carrying solutions to come out of every situation that you might find yourself in.
Раз мы заговорили уже о книгах, пастор, переходим к главному следующему. Какие из них наиболее повлияли на вас?
Книги?
Да.
Хороший вопрос.
What are the books that most influence you?
Я думал недавно над этим вопросом, у меня целая библиотека пасторских книг. И когда возникает какая-то проблема или какая-то мысль, я читаю некоторые книги.
You know, now, for me to answer that question is not easy, because you know, there are so many books and many of them have played an important role in my life. What I've done is that any situation I am, I look for the title that pastor has written on that situation. So whenever I'm going through any situation, I just go to look for pastor's books that address that situation.
Они написаны очень целенаправленно для какой-то конкретной проблемы.
Because his books are not just theory. They are very concrete, very solid, and they address, if Pastor Sunday addresses any issue, know that you have all the answers from A to Z.
И я могу перечислить 5-6, которые читал в последнее время, которые мне очень нравятся.
You know, let me just, I will just, the way I will answer is, I will just give you the last few ones I just read the last few months.
Кто я? Как найти себя?
For example, who am I?
Ты уже богат.
You are already, there is another book we read that is called You Are Already Rich.
Я и мои эмоции.
Another book that I just read recently is I and My Emotions.
Как превратить негатив в позитив.
Another one is how to turn every negative situation into positive.
Кто достигает успеха в жизни?
Another one is who wins in life. So these are a few books that I've just read recently.
Ну, их много.
Вы хотите еще?
Ну да, наверное, на меня больше всего повлияли книги, которые я помогала в качестве редактора писать пастору, потому что когда ты работаешь над книгой, ты больше осознаешь, да. Это основательно. Это, конечно, вот я помогала две книги делать, это...
Любовь?
Настоящая. Истинная или ложная любовь. И «Семь чудес социализма». Вот. И «Семь чудес социализма» так на меня повлияло, что я теперь пишу диссертацию на эту тему.
I helped pastor to edit a few of his books, two of his books. One of them is called The Seven, like, it's a satire. That is called Seven Wonders of Communism. Yes. So these are the wonders that, you know, these funny things that are happening in real life but are not supposed to be there. You know, how communism has just changed people and just messed them up, the best of their lives. So I have a book like that. So she helped me to edit that book. And now she said she's writing a thesis. Their PhD thesis on the subject of my book, on that particular topic. She's developing it. Because to build a better future, you must really understand what happened in the past and analyze it before we could build a better country. So, yes. Это одна книга. И вторая.
Вторая истина или ложная любовь.
The second book I edited for pastor is called True and False Love.
Я тоже считаю, что эта книга, она... учит нас любить, учит строить отношения, учит строить отношения в семье, учит строить отношения вообще друг с другом.
This is a book that teaches us how to love without having self-interest to it, without any self-motivation. So how to love people, how to love our nation, the people around us, how to live in love and relate to each other with love without seeking your own thing.
И после этой книги я могу сказать, что я все знаю о любви.
After that book, I can now say I know everything about love.
Я так думаю.
That's what I think.
Можно я добавлю, да? Добавить. Эти книги, они влияют на людей очень сильно. И одна моя знакомая, с которой мы по Фейсбуку общались, наша общая знакомая в Риге, только что получила посылку с книгами. И час назад мне прислала смс. Я начала читать книгу «Изменись или умри». Я не ожидал, что мне это так затронет. Тесты и практические задания у меня скрипят мозги. Я начала меняться. И я ей прислал 10 книг, и она сейчас сидит и только читает.
Wow.
В Латвии, в Риге, Акита ее зовут. Wow. Только что час назад мне прислала. Книги идут.
Just 1 hour ago, I got a message from a friend of ours who saw my program. She's living in another country in Latvia. And she saw my program. I was talking about Pastor Sunday's books. And she ordered 10 books. And she just said, she's reading the first one now. And she said, I cannot go anywhere. I cannot leave my home. I cannot go to work. I cannot do anything. I'm just reading this book. I'm just reading. This book is totally reconstructuring me. I'm rebuilding my value systems. It's really tearing everything down and constructing me all over again.
Спасибо,
and the book is called Change or Die.
Это такая хорошая мина, которая под дьяволом в разные страны, она изменит мышление людей.
So he's saying the Pastor Sunday's books are like bombs that we are going to just, you know, bomb off all the wrong concepts and the wrong mindset that you are having. You just blow it away and reconstruct you all over again.
У пастора еще есть бомбовые учения. Скажите, пожалуйста, какие из них вам запомнились больше всего, изменили и повлияли на вас?
What about the teachings of pastor? What about the series? What are the ones that have really affected you the most?
Хорошо. Ну, мне больше всего затронуло это учение о том, что Евангелие нужно принести в общество в той форме, в которой, ну, что оно реформировало.
One major doctrine of our Sundays is that we should come, the gospel of the kingdom, that come out of the four walls of the world, of the church, and go and take the kingdom of God to the world. Take the kingdom of God out of the four walls and impose it upon your society.
Я пришел в церковь, я пришел к пастору, религиозным человеком.
I came to this church, like I said, I was already a believer, but I was a very religious one.
У меня было представление, я могу быть прихожанином, или служителем, или пастором. Я могу быть успешным, или неуспешным. У тебя много людей, это успешно, немного, значит, ты неуспешный.
So my own thinking when I came to, before I came to, met Pastor Sunday, was that, you know, you can either be a church member who just comes to church and goes home, or a pastor, or a minister in the church. If you cannot do that, then you just come and go. And so, But the gospel of the kingdom, wow, it brought life to us. You can do anything you feel God is leading you to do. You can follow your heart. Become a writer, become a sports person, become a teacher, become anything you want to do, anything. Not just become a pastor or a minister in the church, but you could be anything and serve God that way.
Храни сердца в сердце своего Христа, имей с ним отношения, и неси через свое дело принципы Божьи.
And of course, another one is that you build a relationship with Christ, with God. Build a very strong personal relationship with God. And then next thing you need to do after that, carry his kingdom. Be a God carrier.
Это так освобождает.
You know, it is such a different freedom that you experience as a believer, Amen. Rather than when you are going to a traditional church.
Это дает радость.
Because you are fulfilled immediately. You can do anything you want for God. What a joy!
Короткое свидетельство. Вот два часа назад подъехали в гостиницу моя знакомая предпринимательница из Одессы. И она специально привезла своего старшего партнера, чтобы получить консультацию у меня. Он не знает, что я верующий. И когда он получал консультацию, мы тут же помолились прямо в гостинице. И я, для всех я бизнес-тренер, для всех я предприниматель. Но на самом деле внутри, я несу Евангелие. Это то, чему учил нас пастор.
Let me give you an example of you being anybody you can and use that to carry the kingdom. Some people, I'm from Russia, right? So some people knew that I'm coming to Ukraine. And there's another city here in Ukraine called Odessa. Right. So one of the business people one of my trainees called his friend and said, this business coach is coming to Kyiv. And, will you meet with him to resolve to come and take consultation from him about your business? So they met me in the hotel. So on one hand, I'm a business coach. But on the other hand, that man committed his life to the Lord Jesus Christ, gave it like God said right there before we left. And that's how Pastor taught us. We carry the kingdom. We are not just in business. We are not just having a job. We are not just making money. We carry the kingdom. Everywhere you are, whatever you do, either as a teacher, you should be as effective carrying the kingdom of God as you do it in the pulpit. Either you are a bank worker, you should be as effective there as you are in the pulpit. Either you are an engineer or a computer scientist, you should be as effective there carrying the gospel as effective as if you were a pastor in the pulpit. Just be as effective carrying the kingdom everywhere. That is what we call the kingdom, the gospel of the kingdom. Representing the kingdom, manifesting God, revealing his values and virtues everywhere you are, as effective as you would do it in the pulpit in the four walls of the church.
Я хочу сказать, наверное, об учении об отцовстве.
Teaching of Pastor Sunday that really transformed us is teaching about fatherhood.
Это учение, которое, оно нужно каждому человеку, и оно нужно было мне. И наша страна, мы не привыкли почитать родителей. Мы не привыкли, у нас общество такое хамское такое отношение к родителям. Очень часто наши родители, они просто ну, забытое, ну, по остаточному принципу. Мы любим родителей, я любила своих родителей, у меня замечательные родители, но по остаточному принципу там, где, ну, время хватило, навестило. Вот. И пастор как раз нас учил о том, что почтение — это как раз и есть то, что ты приносишь в жертву. Хочешь ты, не хочешь, но ты сделай это. Ты сделай этот приоритет, навести своих родителей, позвони, принеси себя в жертву. И я хочу сказать то, что вот отношения с моими родителями значительно улучшили.
Pastor taught us to honor our parents and to honor elders. We never knew what that meant here in the Soviet Union. Because in the former Soviet Union, everybody is supposed to be equal. And that's communism. You are supposed to be equal, you and your parents. Even your parents are not just equal to you. They are supposed to be your servants. They are worse than you. So we look down at our parents. We just use them for our own purpose. We never even knew they were supposed to be honored. We even honor ordinary anybody in the street more than we honor our parents. So there was nothing like that, but until Pastor Sunday began to teach us about honor. And that teaching, honor your parents and honoring elders, honoring people, you know, it totally changed my relationship with my parents, with my mom, because before, my mom always took the last place. You know, if I have any extra thing, then I could share with her. If I have any extra time, then I could have time for her. Otherwise, never thought about her, that she even existed, unless she could do something for me. But now, Pastor taught us that you have to sacrifice your convenience and your comfort to honor somebody you respect. That you have to, honor is when you sacrifice something to prove the point to the person that the person is special to you. You go through some painful process to point it out to the person how important he is in your life. That is honor. And that the person who should respect like that more than everybody else, first of all, should be your parents. And that's what I began to do, and it just changed, totally changed our relationship with our parents.
Если раньше, когда я приезжала в гости к своим родителям, то у меня папа, он, ну, так, ну, типа, привет, и уходил все время, то теперь он уже, ну, он с нами общается, он с нами дружит, он ждет нас, когда мы приедем в гости, почему? Да, и спрашивает, да, почему? Почему ты там не приезжала, почему ты где-то, как у тебя дела? То есть сейчас, ну, начали восстанавливаться именно отношения с родителями.
Like, for example, my father before, you know, each time I meet him somewhere, or come back home sometime, he'll say, oh, hi, hello. And he goes out and I go back and I just, no relationship, no, nothing. But after that, kind of teaching of honor, we began to demonstrate honor to him and to my mom. He couldn't believe it. And now he wants to be around anytime we come around. And he's always even calling us, say, why are you not coming to visit? Please come and sit down and let's hug and let's sit down, let's talk, let's open our hearts to each other. That, you know, parents, children, relationship were restored just thanks to this teaching of our Sunday.
Скажите, пожалуйста, какое влияние, по вашему, имеет жизнь пастора Сандея?
What do you think? What would be the effect of the life of Pastor Sunday? What are the results or the influence of Pastor Sunday's life?
На нас лично?
На нас лично. Какое влияние на нас лично? На нас
лично. Я думаю, что эта жизнь, она будет нести влияние в поколениях.
I think Pastor Sunday's life is going to have effect and it's going to influence for many, many generations to come.
Потому что обычно человек оценивает по делам, по его детям, по поступкам, но здесь идет речь о муже Божьем, о человеке, который положил свою жизнь для того, чтобы принести Царство Божие на землю. Он вложил
свою жизнь. But Sunday has basically laid down his life to manifest the kingdom of God on the earth. So that is going to bring forth a lot of fruit because the seed has fallen to the ground and that seed is going to grow and yield a lot of results in the years to come.
Поэтому я уверен, что эта жизнь — это не жизнь непростого человека, который будет жить в книгах. Но он учит нас всегда рассчитывать свою жизнь на поколение, на сотни лет.
И он учит... Sunday always teaches us to live for generations to come.
И он вложил в себе в книги, в учения,
so Pastor Sunday has invested
передачи,
himself,
церковь.
He has transmitted himself into books, into
учеников.
Cassettes, into teachings, into his doctrines, into his disciples. So he has,
да.
He has distributed himself everywhere. He has multiplied himself into many things.
И мы просто говорим не то, что мы слышим и читаем. Мы 15 лет знаем пастора Сандея.
You know, we, I'm not telling you what we heard or what we think. We've known Pastor Sunday for 15 years. And these are the facts of who he is on daily basis. He's going to remain like that forever.
Он...
Even after he's gone.
Действительно, годами по 20 часов в сутки
Pastor Sunday is doing the same thing, consistent.
В людей,
in raising people,
во все,
consistent,
чтобы
in structure systems,
изменить жизни целых поколений
в мире. Himself, in affecting the nation and every sphere of the society. So he's, he's already there, and his effects are going to be there for generations to come.
Поэтому я абсолютно уверен, что жизнь пастора Сантея уже сейчас можно сравнить с жизнью Мартина Лютера.
Or even right now, while he's still alive, I think his life has already done as much as Martin Luther's life has.
Апостолов Иисуса Христа.
Even the apostles of Jesus Christ, Pastor Sunday's life has done much more than many of the apostles.
Да. Поэтому эта жизнь повлияет на целые поколения по всему миру. На судьбы стран.
Over the nations, over continents.
Да.
Что вы бы хотели пожелать пастору его день рождения?
Would you like to wish pastor anything on his birthday?
Wow. Ну,
еще одно поначалу.
Я вот я все время удивляюсь пастору, потому что люди в постсоветском пространстве недостаточно ценят его. И мы сами тоже еще, может быть, не научились его ценить. Он терпел столько.
Pastor Sunday has suffered so much in this country.
Огорчений.
It's cost him everything to impose his influence over our nation and over the nations of the former Soviet Union.
Издевательство.
They are not used to honoring people like him. People like him are not used to be respected. Pastor Sunday has forced that respect with the price of his life.
Поэтому...
And so, but still, even though he's a legendary person here, but I still believe that our nations don't want to give him the honor that he deserves.
Поэтому я хотел бы пожелать пастору Сандею две вещи.
So there are two things I want to wish him.
Первое.
Number one.
Чтобы он максимально мог исполнить то великое призвание, которое дал ему Бог на 500 миллионов человек
влияние. I wish him that he will be able to fulfill all the dreams that he has. You know, he wants to touch half a billion people. He's, you know, I wish him that he will be able to do that.
И второе, что хотел бы пожелать. Я знаю, что он получит награду на небесах. Но я хотел...
I know he's going to be honored in heaven.
Но я хотел бы пожелать, чтобы он уже при своей жизни увидел добрые плоды своего служения и заслуженное вознаграждение.
I really want to wish him that what he deserves, if you know what this man deserves, he deserves much more than anybody who has ever tried to honor him. And I really wish that he will be honored to the extent that he is really he deserves it, that he will get the kind of honor and recognition worldwide like he deserves.
Да, пожалуйста.
Ну, я тоже хотела бы присоединиться к словам своего мужа и пастора Алексея, и также вот ну, мне хотелось бы, да, чтобы пастор вот просто насладился жизнью, чтобы вот эти все, чтобы вот все эти мучения, которые его преследуют, наверное, на протяжении 20 лет служения на Украине и России, чтобы они наконец-то закончились, и чтобы пастор мог спокойно, полноценно служить, чтобы вот эту энергию, свои силы он мог направить на то, чтобы принести Царство Божие и исполнять свое призвание, ну вот, радостно, да.
For over 20 years, Pastor Sunday, as much as we know Pastor Sunday, for all this period of time, he's been, they have always been fighting him. It's always been a fight with the government, with the system, with the KGB, with the secret services, all nations, countries, the whole machinery, country, national machinery, countries are fighting him, and nations are just again, you know, just trying to crush him. They've not been able to do it, but my prayer is that the pastor will know, will taste what it means to serve God in peace, without, you know, if he will be given the peace, to serve God without the break, even to him, for him to have a few break out of the pressure, if for him to be able to serve God without all those pressures, so that he will experience what it means to just live an ordinary, peaceful life. That's my own desire. So that all the lawsuits will be stopped, so that all the attacks, all the false accusations will be stopped, so that, you know, he will just know what it means to just serve God without all the attacks.
Спасибо вам огромное за такой.
Thank you so very much for your very, very truthful.
Дякуємо вам, дорогі глядачі, що
Thank
ви
you
були
so much, our viewers, for being with us.
Це були послідовники пастора Сандея з Росії.
These are Pastor Sandy's disciples from Russia.
І вони поставили таку жирну завершальну крапочку в нашому нинішньому марафоні.
They are the last ones that in this our marathon of 28 days.
І завтра вже починається святкування пастора дня народження.
Tomorrow is already Pastor Sunday's celebration of his birthday.
Ви напевно побачите цю всю пряму трансляцію.
But this Pastor Sunday's birthday is not ordinary, so it's going to be for 3 days.
І дякуємо, що ви весь час були з нами. Ми надіємося, що ви ще глибше могли дізнатися про унікальність такої особистості, як пастор Сандей, на прикладі живих свідчень його послідовників.
So you will see him, you will see the reports every day, tomorrow till Sunday, and you'll be able to hear more stories and see many great things happening, thanks to Pastor Sunday's life and his celebration. But today is the end of this our marathon that is dedicated to his birthday.
І я також хочу подякувати пастору Сандею за те, що ви мені довірили вести ці програми, які були для мене великою
честю. I also want to use
this
opportunity to say thank you so much, Pastor Sunday, for trusting me with the assignment of leading and arranging all these testimonies and setting them up and putting them up and I'm being the host of this program.
І дякую вам за честь і довіру.
Thank you for the trust, Pastor, because you have so many people to trust and trust with that, but I'm so honored.
Дякую вам, дорогі глядачі, що ви теж були з нами весь цей час, і до зустрічі наступної.
So in 1 hour's time, I will be coming back with Mayowa with all your questions. So everybody that is there, please get ready. In 1 hour's time, we'll be back. But right now,
Bye.
Спасибо.
Thank you, everybody. Get your questions ready. Today is the last day for the questions and answers. Today is the last day that I could answer your questions. I know Mayowa is somewhere. I hope she's going to get ready for the evening. In the next 1 hour, we'll come back live. And of course, you know, my house is already filled up with people. Try to do something here. Let me introduce people who are here. Okay, you already saw the heroes. See who is here. Like to say a few words to them?
Oh, I'm just so glad to be with my friend and with all the other friends that are visiting. It's a blessing. Yeah.
That is who?
My name is Rory. I'm Rory Kay. I'm based in Sweden and Israel, originally from the States.
Okay.
My name is Оксана.
Я учениця пастора Сандея.
I'm also one of those disciples of Pastor Sunday.
Дуже благословлена тим, що була сьогодні.
I'm so blessed to be here today.
Но також, що знаю лично пастора більше 10 років своєї житті.
But the greatest blessing of my life is that I've come to know Pastor Sunday. To just know someone like this is the greatest gift of my life. I've known him for over 10 years now, and you know, I'm the most happiest person just thanks to that.
Конечно, можно очень много говорить о пасторе Сандее.
Познакомимся сначала, представьтесь.
Да, меня зовут Александра.
My name is Alexandra.
Да. Вот, я всегда рвусь, мчусь к моему желанному.
She's from Greece. Athens in Greece.
Yes. Я очень благодарна пастору Сандей. Пастор Сандей
изменил нашу жизнь. I'm still captivated by Pastor Sunday.
У меня были очень такие плохие отношения с дочерью.
Because he saved, he returned my daughter to me.
Она меня просто не уважала, не ценила.
I only had one child, one daughter.
И я...
And she didn't respect me, she didn't honor me. She just treated me bad. I gave her everything. I did everything I could do for her, and I just didn't know what to do to get her back.
Ну, хотя она ездила к пастору Сандею очень часто, и она всегда оттуда приезжала такая радостная, такая вся, ну, вообще счастливая.
She was a Christian, even though she was a Christian, but you know that never changed her attitude to me, towards me, and that never made her to treat me well. Да, я слушалась.
Я всегда на нее смотрела, думаю, Боже, я тоже вместе с ней радовалась. Я всегда задавала себе вопрос. И проходило какое-то время, и Кристина моя угасала. Вот как вянут цветочки, точно так же и Кристина. Я говорю, Кристина, что с тобой происходит? Она говорит, я хочу к пастору Сандей. Ну, как вы все знаете, о пасторе Сандей и ходили, и ходят и легенды такие. И, конечно, я тоже воспринимала все это очень негативно. Я думаю, Боже, что-то такое происходит.
When my wife, when my daughter started going to Pastor Sunday's church, I really got worried because, no, if you go to the internet, if you read what people are saying about Pastor Sunday, yeah, you will not let your daughter go there. You would not want your daughter to go to that church. So I was quite worried. I was saying, you are already bad. And now if you go to that worst place, you will become much more horrible.
И я всегда думаю, что такое у пастора Санде ходить только по рекомендации. Думаю, Боже, ну я не знаю. Мне очень было любопытно и очень интересно. Я всегда хотела с ним познакомиться. И мне тут предоставляется такая возможность, вы не представляете, это сам Бог. У меня были проблемы с документами. И когда,
а с дочкой закончили сначала? Что не знает произошло?
Да, и я, значит, приезжаю сюда, приезжаю, я говорю, Кристина, вот так и так, я вот мне такая возможность, я лечу в Киев. Но я тебе
нет, хотела... она начала ходить сначала. Какие изменения это?
Какие изменения? Ну вот она к пастору Санде приезжает радостно, а потом все, я не нужна, а вот она хочет к пастору Санде. Я ей говорю, Кристина, ну, что вы там делаете вообще? Она говорит, мама, там совсем другая жизнь, там другая атмосфера, все. Я опять сижу, ну все. Ну, проходит время, я ее отправляю, потому что я вижу, ей это нужно. Она
then,
этим живет.
Then later on, that after my daughter started going to Pastor Sunday, she became so happy. She became so glad, so fulfilled, so happy, so joyful. It's like I discovered that was going to be an like a drug for her. That I would send her here there to be happy, because that became the thing, antidote or what they call it, antiseptic or what antiseptic or what they call it.
No, you said right, antidote.
Yes. So that's what I would always send her there to have peace,
yes.
Because she, when she comes from there, she's happy. But I was saying, what are they giving her to drink over there? What is the drug they are giving her to use that is making her to be so transformed and changed? Maybe I could go too. She was saying, maybe I could be. So that's what started making me to think, maybe I should also try to go. If it's something I tell you, Papa. И что попали?
Нет, я что еще перед этим хочу сказать. И один раз Кристина приезжает к пастору Сандею, но я пастора Сандея не знала, приезжает. Мама, мы должны с тобой посмотреть вот это вот служение. Очень хорошее служение. Пожалуйста. И мы с ней смотрели служение по чтению родителей. Я вообще, я это сейчас говорю, так... Я была самая счастливая, когда дочка встала ко мне на колени, когда-то я стояла перед ней. И когда она встала на колени, она мне целовала руки и говорит, мам, прости меня, пожалуйста, я больше никогда так поступать с тобой не буду. Я тебя очень сильно люблю. И я после этого решила, я поеду обязательно к пастору Сандею.
So one time my daughter came back from another visit to Pastor Sandею, because we were living in Greece. So this daughter was flying down from Greece to Ukraine. to sleep as a Sunday for some program. So this time she came back and said, "Mommy, I want to have some time with you." So she came and she demanded that she wanted to see me. Okay. Then she said, "We have just been coached and trained about honoring parents." And she said, "Let me play one of the cassettes for you." So we sat down together. She said, "Mommy, I want you to wash it." And after washing it, my daughter, that has always been beating me up, that has always been abusing me, that's always been just treating me like like the lowest of sort, just like nonsense. This daughter of mine, that I couldn't recognize, I couldn't do anything to please, stood on her knees, dropped on her knees, started weeping, crying, and repenting for every evil thing she has done against me. She started repenting for abusing me. She started repenting for hating me. She started repenting for being ungrateful to me. She started repenting for all the bad, bad, evil things she had done to hurt me. All the hurt that she had brought to my life. She started repenting seriously for this. And started, you know, asking for my repentance and apologize. And, you know, I couldn't believe that this is my daughter. Somebody changed my daughter. From that day, my daughter, even right now that I'm here, my daughter is working. She stopped me from working. She went to Rada work. She's sponsoring me, paying for all my bills, and bought my ticket here. She just like, God just gave me another daughter. So that was when I said I must meet this Pastor Sunday. Pastor Sunday didn't know all these things.
Такое сделать своей маме. Во-первых, я в своей жизни достигла всего. Сама. Я приехала за границу вообще с огромными долгами, не зная языка, и приехала в чужую страну. Вот, я все, что в моей жизни было запланировано, все мои мечты сбылись. Я все это осуществила сама, своими руками. Вот, я трудилась, старалась. И я очень благодарна пастору Сады, что вообще он изменил вообще мою жизнь. В нашем доме Pastor вообще радость, life. Счастье, успех. И Кристина, она стала успешной.
My wife, my daughter, before I was working to support her, I was working to own her. And she would take everything, not even say thank you. But today, my life is full of joy. My home is full of joy, celebration, harmony, peace. You know, I don't have to do anything. She became so responsible. She's trying to pay me back for all the things that she, you know, I've done for her. She's taking care of me. I'm now happy that I have a child. Before I was regretting that I had a child. Now I'm happy that I have a child. And I now know what it means to be a parent and to enjoy it.
Amen.
And now we have Pastor Chris from England is here.
Hello everyone. God bless you.
I'm not going to translate to Russian.
Let's read up for that. I probably need a whole episode of several programs or something to talk about.
We have to do special with you. Especially
yes,
with you. When do you leave?
Next week.
Next week, but you're going to be here after Monday. You don't leave Monday.
Yes, yes.
Good. Who is there? Okay, please. We have to tell Mayowa that we want to do special programs with everybody that will stay behind, especially with her.
So mine, it's, you know, it's a catalog of events and testimonies and but you know, going back, I first sort of like met Pastor Sunday when he launched. I think that was when he launched his book on Church Shift,
yeah, Atlanta.
Yes, in Atlanta, and. It just blew my mind. It came with this entourage of, you know, Russians or whatever. Yeah. Or, you know, Ukrainians, and they were all colorful on stage. I said, these people are just so colorful. But it's not just about the color, but, you know, testimonies and the various things. And what really got me was the fact that there were some drug addicts, ex-drug addicts, that were now pastoring.
Yes.
To me, I mean, and being pastored or general overseered by a Nigerian, I mean, an African and a Nigerian, I thought, no. So I bought all his books, everything on the table I bought. And I think by then he had written that book, Olorua.
Yes.
That book just got me. I cried, I wept. As I read, I wept. I wept because, you know, seeing how there was catastrophe in a family that then brought about a transformation.
Catastrophe.
You know, and I wept because I saw a grandmother who did not give up hope. And as opposed to cursing whenever he misbehaved, all she would say was, Olorua. And, you know, a lot of things. And then it dropped on me that there are a lot more children like this, street trapped in Africa. Some people, and that sort of like, you know, resurrected something, a passion in me, a sort of, you know. And not long after that, I was ministering at a few churches in Lagos. A friend of mine took me. I was ministering at one of his conferences, and then, you know, a lot of pastors, I was ministering for them. And then they took me to a particular place just a couple of days before my return flight back home in England. And then it was a village. And everything I read in that book sort of came back flying.
Wow.
And this was a village in Nigeria where I couldn't believe that in this particular place, to me, everywhere in Nigeria was saturated, but there was no school.
Mm.
I couldn't believe that.
Mm.
And everything in that book started sort of like, and all of a sudden I said to them, listen, we've got to put one in here. Take me to the, they said we had to see the king or whatever, Bale. I think he's the chief of the village, to be able to buy land, we needed to go there, and I said he should take me straight down there. Took me there, secured the land. I didn't have enough money there, but as soon as I got back home, sent the money, we got the piece of land, because I could just visualize. And to me, if he didn't have the opportunity to be sent, I think it was on scholarship.
Yes.
And if that, then I remember that his sister that actually told him,
yes,
if you don't work hard,
yes,
you're going to die in this village.
Yes.
You ain't coming out. And imagine if that word hadn't sunk into him, he really would have died in that village.
Mm.
Yeah. And that came just searching back. I'm thinking,
the word will not have been
yes, that's right. And I'm thinking, no, these children mustn't die like this in this village. And
millions of Pastor Sundays in those villages.
In those villages. And that sort of like, you know, that was the that ministry was actually, you know, given to me as a result of that, where we're just passionate now about helping the village children, getting education to them and all that stuff. And I could go on and on. We just need, you know, because of time, we need a whole lot. Not long after that, he didn't know this. He didn't actually know. I don't think I've even told him this part of it, actually. But that book just blessed me.
Again, for the first time.
He's hearing it for the first time. And then we met again at the Centurion. And that was 2006 at L.A.
Yes.
And he was there in L.A. as well, you know, when they marked the, I think that was the 100th year.
Pentecost.
And yeah, and the baptism of the Holy Ghost at Azusa Street. And, you know, again, we just gelled. And I said, do you remember we met in so-so-so and all that stuff? And then we went our separate ways, and I was busy, business, ministry, everything and that, and raising my children as well. So, and then all of a sudden I heard that he was doing HMT. And even then, for years, I didn't come, but something just kept, because the books, I had the books, you know, the books had really, really blessed my life. Then I came eventually to HMT, and that was it. That was just something else. And I said to him, I said, nobody, everyone else, I wouldn't have an excuse because I met you years and years ago, so I should have been here well before everybody else came here. But he consoled me and said, well, that this was the time God wanted you to come. And that totally, is best, yeah, is the best. And that totally transformed everything. And I mean, I just could go on and on. I just want to thank God, you know, for Pastor Sunday's life. I said, I've got to be here. Even though I'm extremely busy,
yes.
I said, I said, but nobody is 50 twice. Mm-hmm. Another 50th will be there. He will be 100. We don't know where we'll all be by then. Whether we'll be up there or we'll still be here. Or whether Jesus would have come to rapture all of us. I don't know. I said, you know, we need to seize the moment. But I just want to appreciate you. I appreciate God for your life. You know, no matter the battle, victory is yours in the name of Jesus. And I know it's what you carry that is threatening the devil, that's messing the devil up, because lives are being changed, lives are being transformed, people are rising from all over the, even though you've been here years, but all over the world now things are happening, people are coming up with, you know, ministries, and we just want to celebrate you and thank God for your life and ask that the Lord will bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. We love you, we appreciate you, and we celebrate you. Thank you, Pastor Sunday.
That's Pastor Chris from England. And beside her, there is somebody there. Okay, she's coming to the limelight now. Spotlights. Okay, you know this face.
Hello.
You know this face.
Hello, everyone. International. Yes, I'm back in Ukraine. Some of you would swear that I never even left Ukraine. I did leave Ukraine for a short while. I actually am so grateful that I can be part, and my husband and my daughter can be part of this big celebration of Pastor Sunday. I really appreciate the testimonies from the Russians, Ukrainian, people whose lives have been changed over the years from his teachings, principles, kingdom principles, and not just that, but also his own personal lifestyle. And this has been going on for a while, the testimonies coming from Ukraine. It's getting to a point now that curiosity, you know, everywhere I go, people are just curious, what is in Ukraine? Well, the kingdom of God is in Ukraine, right here. Testimonies that, you know,
you'll be here twice this year?
Yeah.
This is the second time you're coming back.
Yeah.
And you're originally from, tell the people who ask you.
Originally from California. That's as far as I want to go.
Right.
But I come all the way from California, United States. What I want to say is that for all of you that listen to us regularly, new people that are coming on, I really would encourage you to go check Pastor Sunday's series. He has lots of topics that he's done, financial, family.
You mean on YouTube?
On YouTube, on his blog, and Facebook Live, I believe. You could still get some there. But I would encourage you to listen to them, especially, I was listening to our guest. He was also talking about his books, how Pastor Sunday's books transform you as a person. And I'm really into the books. Just like the guest said, it's the way it's written so differently, gives you understanding and gives you definition. And actually, by the time you finish the book, all you really need to know in that topic, you really have it. And I took a little break and I was in London for a month. And amazing things happened while I was in London. I found a set of my family listening to Pastor Sunday regularly, and now they were keeping an eye on me because I opened my mouth and I said, oh, I'm here to read Who Am I Again, and Time is Life, and they were literally checking on me like, did you read your book on Pastor Sunday, and what was it that you read? And I found myself sharing with my family the depths of truth that they never knew, really, even though that they're Christians who go to church. But it was, they were so encouraged by what they heard, that there was more to the kingdom of God than just going to church. And they actually became curious and hungry to know more. So I was really encouraged to know that what we are doing here in Ukraine on Facebook is really impacting people's lives. For many of us, if we do have families, you might want to check with your family, because your family might be watching Pastor Sunday and they might need a little explanation here and there and clarity about what the principles of the kingdom is. So I'm so excited that I'm part of this family. Coming back
so
here.
So you introduced them to the YouTube?
Actually, they've been watching you live. They've been watching your series. Some of them, I met some that read your
book.
Were
they not commenting? Obviously,
they weren't. I said maybe two of them. My cousins.
So there are people there who are watching and not commenting, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Not many people comment. A lot of people watch.
Yeah.
A lot of the times I have comments.
Okay.
But a lot of the times I'm.
Yes, absolutely. Yes, absolutely. And I've met some incredible people here in the family of God. I think for me, it is so exciting. You know, people use Facebook. That's great. You like friends, you like people, but honestly, you really never meet those people. But in this family here, we like each other on Facebook.
What? Oh, Lanu Adebayo.
Ah, that's my cousin. I stayed with him. Hi, Lanu.
Lanu say, we are watching you from Liverpool in London. So they never commented, I think, but they are always watching.
They're watching. And I'm so excited that they are, because I know the same transformation we're experiencing here, I know many more people will experience that transformation.
Lanu, it was even his wife is sitting out there.
She needs to give testimony. She needs to, if she can write in and just testify how some of the principle literally changed her right there within that 1 month that I stayed with her. Became a very life-changing experience for her. I hope that she would write in and talk about that. But that was the kind of thing that I was experiencing, that here I am learning about the kingdom of God and actually going out and being able to help people who desire to serve God in spirit and in truth, and being able to encourage them and inform them based on the principles of God. So that was really, really encouraging for me. And I know it's going to be encouraging for other people that are listening. You will be able to do the same thing. So I'd like to say happy birthday, Pastor Sunday, the big 5-0. I am so glad.
And welcome to the club.
Welcome to the club. This is a wonderful club. And maybe you will grow one gray hair by tomorrow.
I hope, because I've been waiting for the gray hair.
Have you sure?
Yes, I've been praying
for it. You've been waiting for the gray
hair. Oh, she missed my message on gray hair.
She did.
She doesn't know.
Yeah,
I did a whole 2 hours message on gray hair.
Was that today? Yesterday?
No. A few weeks ago.
Okay.
You have to give her the link.
Our ministry is okay.
You've got to give her the link.
I need to give it to you. So happy birthday. I'm so grateful to God that my family got to know you. You have indeed transformed our lives. There were things that we knew, but we didn't have a voice. And you have become a voice for the things that we were thinking that the kingdom of God should be. Uh-huh. That the kingdom of God, how it should look, how it should work. But then we found somebody that was bold enough, which is you, to voice out. Not, you know, just say, this is the way it is. With no matter what people say, no matter what people think, you were able to do it. And here we were, just joined on and said, yeah, we got the voice. We're going to join our voice with his voice and just make it bigger and louder and let people know the truth about the kingdom of God and who God is. So I want to thank you for doing that for us and many other people. I'm absolutely grateful. Thank you.
There is another man on that line, same line with you.
I am.
I've tried to get you the old days that you are hiding in your room. Tell us what's happening.
Oh, I have stumbled upon a hidden treasure. And I haven't been able to come out. It's literally nothing from Pastor Sunday.
And you've been here for 2 days, 3 days.
No more than that, maybe. Yeah.
And you've been sucking in some walls, haven't
you? Oh, well, not much has gripped me like this. in a long time, Pastor. I stumbled upon Pastor Sunday's, actually he directed me to Pastor Sunday's messages on how to be a man, how to be a husband, how to be a father. And generally I would pass by those messages and maybe watch
on YouTube.
On YouTube. This is on the YouTube channel, Pastor Sunday's YouTube channel. And when I began to
Sunday at Elijah Official.
Sunday at Elijah Official. Go to playlists, scroll down, you'll see all the sections there. When I began to listen to these, I did it because Pastor Sunday instructed me to do so. But when I listened to just the first one about how a man can know if he's ready to marry, I was so shocked that with all these family ministries, marriage ministries that I've grown up around and you hear them around the world, I had never heard anything like this in my life. I listened to the first one, I was absolutely hooked. Listened to the second one, third one, fourth one. Before long, I was sending these messages to my own disciples and I could not believe what I was hearing, and that all of these messages, 30 hours worth, that's why I've been locked up in my room, even at Pastor's house. 30 hours worth, all in one place, totally free. Click and get that wisdom. I couldn't believe what I've discovered. And I just cannot imagine my life without going through these. It would be the sin of irresponsibility to know that those are there and to not listen to them. So I've been just devouring them. And Pastor, I have to say, even after today, what I've listened to, if I don't make this part of my, you know how one of my missions I feel from God is to explain and reveal Pastor Sunday to the world. If I don't make this aspect of what you have taught and paid a price for, if I don't make that part of my repertoire, I have not fulfilled what God has called me to do. It is unbelievable information that is there. So I really feel if you have not listened to these messages, you have not really heard Pastor Sunday yet. You've heard kingdom, you've heard business, you've heard finances, you've heard national transformation. I thought, I've got it. When I heard this, this is a part of Pastor Sunday's life. That is one of the best gifts he has given so freely. And we can look over it, not realizing the gold, that's the treasure that's hidden in that field. So I encourage everybody, go, I'll tell you exactly how to do it. Go to Sunday at Elijah Official, the official YouTube. Go to playlists. Scroll down until you see those messages that I'm mentioning. Click on the first one. There's 13 messages there. Begin to go through it and make the word become flesh until what he is teaching begins to operate through you so naturally that you can embody this revelation. It is a major piece of Pastor Sunday and his fruitfulness that I knew nothing about, that I slept on for over 10 years. And I'm only discovering it now. That's why I've barely left my room. Every day I'm there until maybe 5 o'clock. I only come out of my room around 5 o'clock. And even now I got a phone call from somebody who listened to one of those messages. And they just wanted to talk about it. They want to talk about it. And they told their mother. And then their mother, you know, Pastor, even now I came down here with stories for you that I'll tell you after we're off air. But I cannot believe the effect these messages are having.
YouTube, Sunday at Elijah Official.
Mm-hmm. And it's all right there. And it's free.
Playlist.
Go to playlist, scroll down. You know, you pay all this money to go to these marriage conferences. I'm sorry to say this, but I grew up around it. I'll just be honest with you.
And you know a lot of ministers.
I know lots of ministers.
Who are just specializing on this.
Who are specializing on it. I've even gone through some of it. And you get some principles.
Snippets.
You get principles that make sense to you in theory, but the practical mechanics are almost never delivered. Pastor Sunday has a way of giving principles, practical mechanics, and opening up concepts. It's like you listen to one message, it whips open a door, and you're into a whole other thing, and you have understanding. You're not just getting knowledge. We don't listen to YouTube messages because we're used to just getting knowledge. Okay, I got more knowledge. I went to the conference. I read a book on love and respect or something. No offense to that book. Great book. But you get some knowledge. What I stepped into on Pastor Sunday's YouTube was so much more than knowledge. It was this level of understanding that began to birth wisdom. I began to see how this makes sense, how the psychology of a woman is like this, and that's why I failed in this area, and if I would have done it this way. And so even after that hour-long teaching is done, suddenly there's just stuff coming to me and ideas, and it changes you as you listen to it. It literally has the power to become flesh in you. There's a grace that accompanies these messages. I can't imagine being a disciple of Pastor Sunday and not having had devoured this. No matter who you are, no matter how long you've been married, you know, no matter you have children, you don't have children, step into this river, and this thing is going to carry you to realms you did not know were possible before. It's changing my life already in the last few days, Pastor.
Wow.
So I'm Pastor Derek from Canada. I'm Pastor Sunday's white son.
What's your Yoruba name?
My Yoruba name is Obafemi. They named me that at a church we have. But Pastor, I can't talk about anything else. I can't talk about anything. That's been sitting there for how long you've been teaching this. You know, North America needs this information. With the divorce rate, with all that's going on, with our desire as a church to restore the family, and these teachings are not out there, I'm telling you. So we have to package this, we have to find a way to get this out there, but for now, it's sitting there for free. I don't know any minister in the world that would give away that kind of information for free. I don't know anybody in the world who would. You would pay for 30 hours of that kind of information, tens of thousands of dollars. And it's sitting there for free. And I think that's why people pass over it. When something is so easily given, we tend to we devalue it. But when I heard the first one, suddenly I was hooked. Never heard anything like it in my life, Pastor.
And of course, then the next one.
The next one, the understanding the psychology of a woman and... You just have to know the people that have called me after they've listened to this, you know, they can't believe that you could know all this because it's accurate. They can't believe that you would know this. And they say this is so accurate, and they describe situations they were in and all of it coming from one man sitting in front of an iPad. just giving it away for an hour. Somebody paid such a high price, and we sit down and listen to it like that. The psychology of a woman, how to make friends with your child, how to raise children, you know, the way what a woman is expecting from a man. How could any man not listen to that? Every man is interested in a woman. And Pastor Sunday is giving away keys to accessing one of the greatest gifts that God could give us as men, one of the greatest treasures. My whole mind has been just spun by this. Oh, Lord.
What about for women? Yeah. Because you are a man talking. Is there anything there for women?
There's just as much for women there as there is for men, and I tested it. I sent one or two to a particular young lady, and she could not believe that any man could know these things. She didn't even understand herself. She didn't even understand her own responses to men.
Why that was happening to her?
Yeah, and it was like you had painted a roadmap or painted a movie of here's what happened, here's why. And what really threw her was how could any man know this and be able to deliver it so succinctly in such a way that it makes sense? She began to understand things that she never understood before.
As a woman.
It's one of your greatest gifts, Pastor, to the world. I really believe that now. And I've been around you for quite a while. It's one of your greatest gifts that I overlooked. And yet so necessary. You know, one of the things Pastor Sunday said is that you think you can enter into marriage because you come of age. And in reality, what would we do anything without first studying, without first learning how, without first trying to understand? All of this is right there for you to be fully equipped to enter into marriage or family or having children without the landmines going off in your face. You know, you don't have to go through the hard years. You don't have to go through certain things when you can have a preemptive preparation for free, sitting right there. So this 50th birthday, I'm thanking Pastor Sunday for so much. It's a whole new chapter for me of what he understands that has been so overlooked as part of his ministry and life. It's unbelievable. And you think, some people think, well, Pastor Sunday has such a great family because his wife has this temperament, or he has this temperament, or his kids are just brilliant. But when you begin to dive into these messages, you see that it didn't happen by chance. They built this intentionally. They intentionally built their family. They intentionally built their children. They intentionally built their marriage. And they took these key principles and just were consistent with them. And so any success can be reproduced. Behind every success, there's a secret. He's giving away these secrets that if you can make them become flesh, if you can adopt them, if you can study them, if you can learn them, like anything else, you can reproduce that marital success. You can reproduce those children. You can reproduce that family. Because it's based on principles. And those principles are all there on YouTube, 30 hours worth.
So maybe that's one of the reasons why I needed to stay back. Yeah, it would be this my prison. Because without it, it wouldn't have come out that way. I wouldn't have released it. No time to preach this thing. Otherwise,
I can't imagine.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I can't imagine not hearing these things.
All things work together.
For good.
Yeah.
Like, Pastor, I want to, you know, I'm young and zealous and inexperienced, but I want to become an expert in this area. Mm. This is just
and
so.
And you are also talking about the need to really package it to the world.
Yeah, that's
that
the question.
The world needs to know. We need to find a way, right?
Yeah, because I feel a little bit nervous that they're sitting on YouTube. That all of that is there. So I'm devouring them because who knows what can happen with YouTube. So I'm devouring them now and I'm making notes, but I'm thinking if there was a way to download them, store them,
and then
package them through some of our connections and then distribute this properly. There is no, what I know of, there is no marriage or family ministry that would be teaching this. And I'm not mentioning names, but I've been around some of them. I work with some of them. I've never heard these things before. So practical, so systematic, so doable that any marriage can be successful. Any family.
Easy.
Can be
easy. Easy.
So now that's my new burden is, you know, how to embody this message, how to package this message. I'm just doing what I always do with you, sir, is how to make this just a part of me.
Flesh.
You know?
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much, Pastor. We have a few more minutes to go. We have a few more minutes to go before I begin to answer your questions with my wife. My wife got a new hairstyle. But when I first saw it first, I didn't like it, but now I like the way she put it on the corner. That looks better to me. That looks better to me. It looks fine. Very fine, this one. But when the air was blowing, I was scared. Now I'm not so scared anymore. And then I have some people working on me to be more sophisticated. So that might have helped. Well, so this is the birthday girl. And the champion, the Superman, that has been able to cope with her. What do people have to say before we close? We have like 5 minutes to go before Payo sends up my video.
Okay. Happy birthday, Dr. Sunday. And then Pastor Chris said something which was really profound for me. Yeah. When she said, you were the voice for those of us who believed in certain things. I realize often or not, when you believe in something and nobody believes in what you believe in, you keep quiet, you know, because you're thinking, am I in the wrong, you know? But, you know, so, you know, when she said that, you know, I totally, you know, agree with her. But one other thing I would say is, as scripture says, when Jesus called Nathanael, and he ran to Peter and said, we found the Messiah, you know. I mean, that's it. I'd heard about your name in the past. No. I knew people talked about, oh, this Nigerian pastor who was doing wonders in Ukraine, you know. And I said, okay. Well, it's a good thing a black man is doing wonders in Ukraine, you know. Mm-hmm. But then my wife has a habit of always searching into the internet and discovering things, you know. So she came to me and she said, I found this pastor in Ukraine. You need to listen to him. I know you'd agree, you know, you'd really, really like him because he says the things you believe in, you know. So I said, oh, okay, I'll connect and, you know, hear him, you know, preach. And I think I can't remember the first message I listened to, but I think the first message I'll say really caught my attention was the one you were talking about, girls who grew up without their fathers. You know, and somebody just said, you know, it was amazing. If there had been a woman preaching it, I would have understood it more. It would have made more sense to me, you know. But I'm thinking, how come a man is preaching what a woman feels like? You know, but then, you know, I listened to it and I just got hooked to it. And as someone said, there are millions of us out there who listen to you but never pass a comment. Yeah. I think I've only said good morning about twice or something. Majority of us just listen to it and, you know. But then it's been a blessing, especially the way my wife's life has been.
Transformed,
you know. It got to a stage I was thinking I was losing hair.
because she took off.
She took off, you know. But then I believe, you know, that's what it's all about, you know. Because I remember, because we both didn't have fathers in our lives, you know. I remember we used to have a bit of a friction whenever she brings this father issue. You know, and I used to tell her, hey, you're not the only one who grew up without a father. But then
She needed it.
Mm-hmm. I had crucified it. You know, I had come to that place of acceptance that, look, God is my father and that is it. I'm happy with that, you know. But then in her life, she needed it, you know. So I'm happy she found the father she needed.
You know. Okay, thank you, Evans. About to go now.
I'm just lost for words. And this is my third time of coming to Ukraine. The way that Dr. Sunday Dillinger has just celebrated my birthday, I'm still in that place. I am so overwhelmed. I'm overwhelmed here with my Facebook. The birthday wishes haven't stopped. They still can come in, even though it was yesterday. And it's all because that Daddy God led me to DSA, my best mentor in the whole wide world. And I'm just overwhelmed. As I'm sitting here, I'm thinking about everything. When the Bible talks about God restoring the lost years, I only saw it as words, but now I see it in reality. And I see it in the person. Daddy God has chosen to love me through Dr. Sunday Adeline. So when I say he is my best mentor in the whole wide world, please don't take offense. Please do not take offense. Unless you know my story, you will not appreciate when I say he's my best mentor in the whole wide world, and he's also my daddy. You don't know. So please, if you don't know, go and watch my life stories, which is now on YouTube. Then you will understand to who's been forgiven much, appreciates much. I know where I have come from. I've come from a very dark place. And it's in my older years that Daddy God has led me to deliverance so I can smile. So I don't take it for granted. I do not take this for granted. So that is why I say he is my best mentor. I've never had a mentor in my life. I've asked for mentorship. It never happened. But you know what? And when it didn't happen, it really did hurt me. It hurt me a lot, but that's another story. But, you know, Daddy God has given me the best mentor, the best. So that is why I say he's the best mentor in the whole wide world. For me, maybe not for you, but for me, he's my best mentor. And because of him, Daddy God is bringing out all these things that I never thought would be capable. I never thought I'd get to this place. So it is out of a sense of deep gratitude when I say, and when I make that expression that he's my best mentor in the whole wide world. And like I did in a series recently, you know, Daddy God is just manifesting his love through the person of Dr. Sunday Adelaja. So I really want to, you know, thank you so much. You know, I don't have the words to say.
Okay, what about if you think in the sense that there are many other people there that really need this, that don't even might not even know it's possible for them to?
Trust me, it will happen for you. I don't know your situation. And just like Dr. Sunday did when he started the self-confidence series at the beginning, he told us about his life story, the whole life story, that if God can do it through Dr. Sunday, he can do it for him, and he can do it for me, he can do it for you. At one point in time, I will not have the confidence to say to you that God will do it for you. But because he's done it for me, and he's doing it in such a magnificent way, such a loving way, such an elaborate way. I mean, this is my second home. I have everything. I have a home away from home. Who does that? Daddy God does that. He will restore the lost years. And for those of you that have lost so much, please go and listen to all the series, all the messages on YouTube.
They're on my YouTube page. Your testimonies are there.
Yes,
direct them there.
Well, if you go to Anastasia McDonald on YouTube.
You have YouTube too?
I have a YouTube there. They're there.
Because they're on mine too.
Yeah, I'm not even talking about my YouTube. I'm talking about...
Yeah, I didn't even know you have YouTube. That's good.
I'm talking about your
YouTube channel. Anastasia McDonald story.
Yes, go and listen to them so that when you listen to those stories, you will begin to appreciate the power, the mercy, the love of God. It doesn't matter that even in your older years, because when God led me to Dr. Sunday, I was 50. I just turned 54, so that's 53 last year. So in my mid-50s, he's done it. So I don't know what your situation is. He's got your back. He's connecting. But at this point in time, I'm telling you that go to Dr. Sunday Adelaja's YouTube page, Sunday Adelaja Official. Go and listen to all the videos. Go and watch them. Your life will never be the same again. I've been a Christian for 30 years. There was no real transformation. But as soon as, I don't like to call him God because to me he's Daddy God. I moved from God to this
Daddy
thing.
God, yeah.
Daddy God will do amazing stuff in your life. You will never know. So please go and watch his videos. Whatever you're looking for, the answers are there, as Pastor Derek was saying a few minutes ago. There's everything that you need. You will not fail. You cannot fail. You cannot fail. So I'm overwhelmed. I'm lost for words. And I'm deeply grateful to Daddy God first. And I'm deeply grateful to my best mentor in the whole wide world for being the person that he is. Open up his house, his everything that I can be. This is just a tip. What you're seeing, what you see on Facebook is just the tip. It's just the tip of what, you know, the best is yet to come. And I say to God that I want to be a real blessing to all those He puts in my hands. As I see Dr. Sandy do it, that's how I want to be a blessing to him. I want to wipe people's tears. I want to be. I want to do likewise. So I know time is going. So that's a little for me here.
So I will just read one comment before I go.
Okay.
Just a few minutes. This is what she's setting it up already. One person is writing, Monica is a, okay, Pastor Sunday is most of us best mentor, okay? Mm-hmm. So no offense on that.
Okay.
But I'm jealous nevertheless. I'm jealous. And what makes me jealous of you is because you have been to Ukraine and I've not. Well, that's another time. Anastasia is going to remain here for this next week, and I think my wife will do an interview with everybody, and so she will be able to tell you how she was able to come here. What did she do? How did she go about with her job? How did she come? Maybe her husband paid for her and did all that, but the husband is here now. So how are they able to manage it and all that? So, you know, we will ask them all those practical questions and let's see. And of course, we are starting our program 4 minutes. 4 minutes more to the next live broadcast. Wow. It's like nonstop these days now, right? So now I'm going off because we need to set up the next camera. So in the next 4 minutes, 5 minutes, we'll be back with Mayowa with the questions. All right, blessings. Patty is always putting love for you. Patty Bafu is just putting love for you. All right, guys, see you in 5 minutes. Blessings.